Hello YouTube. Owner of this specific laptop changed LCD screen without removing battery. Probably the reason for mistake was that Lenovo T580 has one swappable battery, but inside of the laptop there is one additional battery, which can only be accessed if you unscrew bottom plastic cover. Consequently, screen backlight fuse was blown while changing the screen. As even if laptop is turned off, voltage is present on LCD screen connector. Image is visible on the screen, but very dim as there is no backlight. Interesting enough, it looks brighter on the camera than in real life. I used microfiber cloth beneath the computer to not scratch it while working on it. First step is to remove external laptop battery. For next few steps, you can see tools that I used during disassembly of this computer. First, set of screwdrivers. And we won't need hand cream, so we can store it for later. But we'll need some plastic tools for prying things apart. Now, disassembly part. Unscrew all screws on bottom plastic cover with Phillips head screwdriver. They are by design held in place on bottom cover, so you won't lose any screws when removing the bottom cover. Use guitar pick, old credit card or something similar and gently pry between bottom cover and palm rest all around the computer housing. I suggest not to use any metal tools as they can leave marks on plastic computer parts. When all plastic clips are released, you can remove bottom cover. Now we should remove internal battery before doing anything else. Disconnect connector from motherboard first. Then unscrew all Phillips head screws that hold the battery in. Just make sure that you remember which screws go where, as motherboard screws could be a bit different. I would like to add here, before going any further, that you can access backlight fuse without removing motherboard. It is hidden just below LCD connector where cooling fan is. You would need to remove RAM, entire cooling system, and protection sticker foil under cooling system. With this, you can access backlight fuse with motherboard still in place. I was not aware where exactly the fuse is located or if there is some other problem on the motherboard. So I rather removed it and checked the motherboard out of the computer. With this clarified, let's go ahead. With bottom cover removed, we can remove keyboard, if we want to remove motherboard later of course. Fun fact, in this model of a computer, screws from the bottom core holds keyboard in place, so it is quite neat design. With plastic tool, gently pry on bottom part of keyboard. It will slide under top cover even more. When it is under almost to the top of the buttons, it can be lifted up from the bottom part and finally pulled out. Do not forget to disconnect both of ribbon cables first, before totally removing it. Close computer back and turn it around. Next step. Remove RAM sticks and disconnect all ribbon cables on lower side of the motherboard. Unlock connectors and gently pull out the ribbon cables. For removing of the hard drive, unplug connector on the motherboard and remove cable from it. Drive can be removed by simply pulling by the black tab. Speaker connector needs a bit more force for disconnecting. I used two plastic tools at the same time and wiggled the connector out. Wireless card is held in place by one Phillips head screw. With it removed, it just slides out. Take a note how antennas are connected to it. It is the best to plug it in the same place as they were originally. Otherwise, you could have some troubles with Wi-Fi signal down the road. Disconnect the ribbon cables on the top part of the motherboard. Those are for LCD screen and camera. Take additional unused antennas out of the way. Then I started removing all motherboard screws that hold motherboard in place with Phillips head screwdriver. Some are black and some are chrome color. Best to memory where goes which. Or just take a picture before proceeding. Before removing it, I decided to remove cooling system first. Unscrew all screws that are holding it in place. Disconnect fan from motherboard. With all unscrewed and disconnected fan connector, you can lift it straight up. With now getting more space, I removed metal part on right and left side. Those two parts hold motherboards firmly in place. Quite good design, I would say. As screws were previously removed, just slide both of them horizontally in direction towards center of the computer. There was a lot of dried thermal paste on the CPU and the GPU. I cleaned it with motherboard still in place to not mistakenly get any debris where it should not be. First, I carefully used paper towels to scrub off all the mess. Make sure that you do not get paste in any of connectors or other parts where it does not belong to. If you look carefully on the video, you can see that I screwed some screws back on to hold motherboard in place. I did that as I didn't want that motherboard would wobble around while cleaning thermal paste from it. For some separate bigger particles of thermal paste, I also used tweezers. Final cleaning was done with help of toothbrush and isopropyl alcohol. Yes, I know. We forgot to disconnect network card from its antennas. I used plastic guitar pick and pried it off. As said previously, remember in which order they were connected. Now that we have thermal paste removed, I removed motherboard screws that I put in just to hold motherboard in place while cleaning it. Motherboard can be then lifted straight up. Straight after removing motherboard, I peeled off black protection stickers. I did not record that part, but you can start at one corner and gently peel while supporting motherboard with other hand. Do not break the board and use common sense. It is possible to remove both of them in one piece if you are careful and take your time. I like to stick them directly on clean desk. With this, glue on foil keeps its thickness, so it is easy to put it back on later. Time for finding blown fuse. In general, backlight fuse is near LCD connector on motherboard. For this, use multimeter in continuity mode. If there is no continuity through fuse, you know that it is blown. I checked multiple ones, but the backlight one on this specific computer model has mark F2605. It is SMD fuse. You should replace it with SMD fuse size 0603 and following specification, 32 volts and 3 amps. I did not have it available, so I just unsoldered it and replaced it with solder blob. You should be careful with this, as if you do same mistake again, there will be damage something else on the motherboard and maybe not so easy to fix. I tested if screen backlight works after bridging the fuse. With motherboard in computer housing, fixed with two black screws, RAM in motherboard, and other ribbon cables connected, I tried to turn on the computer with just AC charger connected. It showed Lenovo splash screen. For test, this was enough and I quickly turned off the computer, as there was no cooler in place for the test. With test successful, I continued with assembly of the computer. First, I put plastic protection film back on the motherboard, and then screwed metal plates which hold motherboard in place. Then I connected speakers to the motherboard. Next, WiFi card. Use proper screw to secure it in place. Connect antennas to wireless card. Keep an eye to which connection you connect which antenna, as they should be connected in same manner as originally. What is also important? Cables and antennas should be routed as originally, and they should be freely moving. On example, if antennas are stuck somewhere, they can be damaged when opening and closing laptop screen. When I had all connected and routed nicely, I focused on cleaning cooling system from dust and removing old thermal paste. As previously on CPU and GPU, I used paper towels first to remove most of the paste residue. For a final wipe, I like to use isopropyl alcohol. Dust can be easily blown out with blowing into the cooler. It can be a bit messy, but what can you do? Final wipe on graphics chip and CPU with isopropyl alcohol, and we are ready for applying new thermal paste. Use small pea-sized blob on every chip surface. I like to spread it around to cover whole chip before assembly. Anyway, it is hard to do worse thermal compound application than they do it in the factory. Gently put on cooling system and screw all the screws in. Tighten them in cross pattern to get proper seating. Do not forget to connect cooling fan connector to the motherboard in all of the excitement. Insert stick of RAM, hard drive, or in my case SSD. Connect it to the motherboard and again be careful how you route the cable. Double check if you have all screws that hold motherboard in place and all cables connected to the motherboard. They should be all routed nicely without obstructions. With this, let's continue with keyboard. Connect both ribbon cables. Make sure they sit in fully before clamping them down. Slide in top part of keyboard under palm rest first. Then pull it down till it jumps in place. We are missing battery, so good time to fix that. Screw it in and connect it to the motherboard. Let's test computer once more before mounting bottom cover on. Good as new. Backlight working as it should. Turn it off. Put bottom cover back on. Press all around so all clips slide in place. Torque down all cover screws and you are almost done. Slide external battery in and you are good to go. If you like my videos, please consider liking and subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching!